So you have learned that when we apply the ng model directive on an input field, Angular creates a form control object under the hood and associates that with this input field. You also learned that we have another class in Angular called form group. So we have form control, which represents one input field, and form group, which represents a group of form controls. Now each form is a form group because it has at least one control. Now on the top, here's the form element. Angular by default applies a directive here that is called ngForm. Let's go to angular.io and look at the documentation of the ngForm directive. So here we type ngForm. You can see it's a directive. Let's have a look. So this directive, just like ngModel, is defined in angular/forms. Now if you scroll down, under selectors, look at the selectors. The first selector references any form elements that doesn't have ng-noform and form group attributes. So you know what these selectors are. When we create components, when we create directives, we set a selector. And when Angular sees an element that matches that selector, it applies that component or directive on that element. So with this first selector here, when Angular finds a form element without these attributes here, it's going to automatically apply the ngForm directive on that element. So here's our form element. We don't have those attributes, which means Angular is going to automatically apply the ngForm directive here. Now we can create a template variable to get a reference to that ngForm directive. So once again, I'm going to declare a template variable. We can call it f, as in short for form, and set it to ngForm. So previously we used a similar technique. With our input field, we defined this template variable first name and set it to ngModel. Now here, instead of ngModel, we set this template variable to ngForm. Okay. Now back in the documentation of ngForm directive, under outputs, you can see this directive has an output property, ngSubmit. And as you remember, we use output properties to raise custom events. So this directive exposes an output property called ngSubmit that we can use in our event binding expressions. So back here, we can use event binding and bind ngSubmit event to a method in our component. Let's call this method submit. Now, as an argument to this method, I want to pass f, which is a reference to our ngForm directive. I want to show you that directive in the console. So let's go to our component and add this method submit that takes f. Now here we simply log it in the console. Now back in the browser, I'm going to type banana here and some comment, submit the form. Now look in the console. So here's our ngForm directive. It's an object with a bunch of familiar properties. So all those pair properties you saw earlier, we have them here as well. We have dirty and pristine, which tells us if the form as a whole is dirty or not. We have errors, which returns all the errors in the form. We have touched and untouched. We have valid and invalid, just like before. Now look at this form property. This form is of type form group. So just like we have form control, which represents one input field, we have form group, which represents a group of input fields. If we expand this form object, again, we see those pair properties. So this is the actual form group object under the hood. And when the ngForm directive is applied to a form element, it basically creates this object and it exposes these pair properties here, which are computed properties, which basically delegate to this underlying form group object. So this means in our submit method, we can access properties like f.valid, f.invalid, f.errors, if we want to do something programmatically. Now back here, we have one more important property called value. Let's look at this. So value is an object with two properties, comment and first name. And you can see the values I put in the form. So those name attributes we assigned to each input field determine the name of the key or the property in this value object. So this value object is a JSON representation of our form. In a real world scenario, in our submit handler here, we can simply get f.value and then we have a JSON object that we can send to an API on the server for persistence.